Bones rely on connective tissue made of proteins like collagen to remain strong and resistant to fractures. Now, mutations that affect the way collagen coils into a triple helix can affect the strength and integrity of bones in such a way that causes osteogenesis imperfecta, or brittle bone disease.
The gene that codes for the alpha-1 component of type 1 collagen is COL1A1, and it's essential for building the collagen fibers like you see here, normally in the form of a triple helix. If you follow the colors closely, you can see the red spiraling around the structure, and the green and the blue doing the same thing. The COL1A1 gene can be found on chromosome 17 in the human genome. Chromosome 17 is about 81 million base pairs long, and the COL1A1 gene can be found about halfway down. The COL1A1 gene spans 51 exons and over 18,000 base pairs of DNA. After transcription and splicing, the mRNA has 4,395 nucleotides of coding region between the start and stop codons. And after translation, we get a protein with 1,464 amino acids. Remember, we just divided 4,395 by 3 and subtracted 1 because this last codon doesn't code for an amino acid. The stop codon is just empty. Now, most of the amino acids in the collagen molecule itself are glycine, because this is actually what allows the collagen to form that beautiful triple helix we saw, the sort of turning back on itself. A lot of glycines make that possible. So any allele that might disrupt the glycines in these positions are associated many times with osteogenesis imperfecta. But one mutation of the COL1A1 gene contains a G to T, a guanine to thymine mutation at position 1245 of the coding region. Now, using the genetic code, which we learned about in lesson 3 and that you can find in the instructor's notes on this page, I want you to determine the expected amino acid change from the top to the bottom sequence, and then select the type of mutation that best categorizes this change to the T allele. If you have any trouble answering this, you might want to go back and review mutations from lesson 6.